You know, one thing we're always aware of with the many calls and the folks that we connect with through the 700 Club Canada is that there is a lot of loss sometimes in life. And our guest today has experienced a lot of loss. Terry Posthumus, thank you so much for joining us. But what I love about your story is that it ends well. But back in the beginning, there has been loss after loss, pain after pain that you've experienced. And you're a joyful man today. So I would like you to help us to get from all of that pain to the joy that you experienced today. It really began, the first loss was pretty tremendous. You were in kindergarten and your father passed away.
I went to school one morning and when I came home at noon, he was gone. And there's just no real closure in something like that. And I don't think there's any way for a child to really fathom really what's happened there.
Right.
I've been a fatherless child and it's presented its challenges.
Yeah. What was the impact initially? A little bit stunned in the family? You watched your mother and everyone grieving over this.
Yeah. So I'll touch on that, but I'll also let you know that right away there was community around that came and surrounded my family. And those are some of the most poignant is the wrong word because it's sad, but there's some of the biggest memories that I have is how that community supported our family. You know, as a little boy, you just want to have a dad.
Yeah.
And that's really
that
how it hit me
from
that
point
hardest.
On. Right.
But one thing I never lost sight of, because of the community of our church and family, was that God was my father. And even as a young boy, I guess I understood that. I wouldn't have been able to articulate it, but I knew it deep down in my heart.
Well, and fatherhood from there is something that you know an awful lot about. I mean, in actual fact, 11 children can be credited to your name. And so you've had a magnificent journey, but in the midst of all of that has also been more loss.
Yeah, for sure. And probably some of the greatest challenges to my faith came in that. We have lost three children and also a molar pregnancy. I remember when my son Ezekiel died, he died in my arms. He was 16 days old. Mm-hmm. And they had done everything that they could to try to help him to live. And I remember when he died, and after having already lost my daughter Sherry and my daughter Gracie, I was like, God, are you kidding me? Like, what else, you know, are you going to take? But once again, you know, even, you know, standing at the graveside of my little boy, I was surrounded by this community of people who picked us up and held us up and wouldn't let us fall. And one particular friend just wouldn't let me let go, you know, of God, and reminded me that God understood what I was going through. And that's not a trivial little thing. Like, I knew the sorrow for sure. Through walking this out and through the process, I also learned that God doesn't forsake us and he doesn't leave us and he really does know our pain.
Right. Mm-hmm. On the way to getting to that truth, you went through probably, I would imagine, you prayed very hard that God would rescue your child.
Yeah.
You prayed that God would come through, that there would be a miracle story here.
Yeah.
And you watched as the Lord gives.
Yeah,
and the Lord takes away.
For sure. I've seen the miracles as well. Mm-hmm. My daughter, Kara, my oldest daughter, was 1 pound, 9 ounces when she was born.
My goodness.
And she was 14 weeks premature, mm-hmm. and they didn't give her any chance of survival. But I saw God, you know, raise up this beautiful little girl who today is married and an artist and living her life. You know, she's just an incredible story.
Two totally different outcomes,
yeah,
right?
But you have the same faith for the one that passes.
Yeah.
And I prayed as fervently, but God had a different story in mind.
Right.
There.
What do you do with those moments? I know for my life, when I've gone through some loss, sometimes it feels like God's a little bit farther away.
Oh, for sure. I mean, there are times where it's like the faintest of hope. And I think sometimes we even just have to rely on the fact that God was there before because we can't feel him or we can't hear him.
Right.
And so it really comes down to faith, trusting that he's there, right. You know, as he was before.
Did you have any strong words for the Lord? Uh-huh. Were you that kind of expressive person?
I understand the psalmist.
Yes.
Yeah, I absolutely do. You know, I mean, I won't say what some of my prayers were because this is a family show, but I mean,
wow.
It was hard.
It was intense.
And you get, sure you do. You get intense. I mean, if I can get angry, you know, in traffic, imagine the, you know, because it's, you know, maybe not going the way I want it to. Imagine how angry when a child that you want with all of your heart, that you would give anything to have, is taken from you.
Right.
There was some pretty deep feelings there.
Right.
But God can take that, hey? Mm. And I'm not gonna say he welcomes it, but he'd rather have us talking to him that way than mm-hmm. to turn around and stop.
And so the loss goes on because it didn't just end there. You were married to a beautiful woman.
Yeah.
Her name was Lorraine.
Yeah.
And what happened?
Well, Lorraine had breast cancer. And after 3 years of fighting, valiantly, it ended up coming back and it killed her. Well, it was actually pneumonia that killed her, but it doesn't really matter what killed mm-hmm. her. She died.
And so,
you know, I had my soulmate, my mm-hmm. the love of my life, mm-hmm. die in my arms. Mm-hmm. And that was hard.
That was hard.
Yeah, that was painful hard. Like mm-hmm. it was actually physically painful. Mm-hmm. But you know, one of the things I got to say again, and maybe this is the whole point, you know, and that we go looking for this. We weren't alone. We were never alone. Mm-hmm. And it's not just that God was with us, but there were people there with us who held us and loved us. I remember my daughter Alyssa. She turned 5 the day after Lorraine passed away. Mm-hmm. Do you know that our church community threw a birthday party for her, and mm-hmm. and people went out, you know, and they bought her gifts and they brought food, and it was a sad celebration.
You've mentioned community so many times.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's part of what we have to stay in when we're in the grieving process, mm-hmm. is to allow others to kind of hold you up a little bit.
I think so.
Yes. I know that you travel, you tour, you're a musician, a songwriter. Mm. How has the loss actually made you better at the gifting and the call of God in your life?
Yeah, well, I think that they work together, mm. you know, and what songwriting has done is it's given me a voice to really distill
Express.
My feelings, mm. you know. I could talk and talk and talk, but when you write a song, you know, you've got 3 minutes, three or 4 minutes.
Right, you have to really convey.
Mm-hmm. And I think that helps get to the real heart of the matter.
Yeah.
And a lot of the healing, if you listen to the songs on my CDs, you'll see where the healing is happening in those songs. And it's pretty awesome.
Right. What is the number one thing you've learned about God through the loss?
That he will absolutely never leave us or forsake us.
Mm, felt him there.
Oh, absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, when I was angry at him, when he felt a long way off, when I couldn't see through my pain, he was there. Mm-hmm. And he was instant. I love the story about how Jesus was walking on the water, and it says, when Peter cried out to him, it says, instantly.
Instantly.
I know that. I know that feeling. It's true.
Right. So what is the hope that you give someone today? I know someone might be struggling with a recent death or even a divorce. A divorce is like a death.
That mm-hmm. is hard. I would say that understand that God loves you with this perfect love. And I don't even have words for what that is, but it's so far beyond what we can understand love. His grace is way beyond what we understand, and that's how he holds you.
Yes.
That valuable.
So, thank you, Terry. Yeah. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for being so vulnerable about all of that, that painful stuff, and taking it, turning it into beautiful music that is touching people's lives.
Thank you.
You know, I don't know what you're going through, but you can absolutely rely on the fact that God is faithful, that he sees you, that he's walking with you the same way he did in Terry's life. And so be blessed today. Take hope, take courage today. Mm-hmm. God's with us. Thanks for joining us. We look forward to being with you again. Until next time, see you then.
To contact us, phone 1-855-759-0700. You can email us at cba@700club.ca. You can now like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter or Instagram.